We set out to create an urban athletic apparel line inspired by love and the idea that our generation is so extraordinary. What matters is what we do. This is our journey.
As the world becomes a little village, my eyes open anew to a whole different settings. My hands can now stretch to a barking dog. Now I hear and feel light caressing my cheeks that were once frail. The little cocoon that once held my dwellings has now caved in. And though tight-lipped, big little smiles, the old white, black, blue, yellow, and red opens wide. We all sing as one. My perspective that used to give room for my emotions down south has withered away the passing wind. Appetite skipped class for China. But even walls have ears. Our impact to our world takes you and I. Mother Teresa baked the cake. Mahatma Gandhi lit the stove. Dr. King iced it. It's now our era to cut and serve the cake. A candle loses nothing by lighting another candle.
So Christa didn't know that I used to be a goalie, and she's all talking like she's D1. I told her she wasn't gonna score on me. That's what's happened so far. She shot 4 or 5 times. Nada. Stopped.
Ray Nora, Ray Jumubindia, Gornama. Malin, Abdul Gadir, Kadial Gorgamal, Malgoa.
We need peace. Peace for all Sudanese. Peace. Salam. Awzin, salam. Fi Janoub, fi Shamal, fi Darfur, fi Al-Gharib, fi Al-Sharik. Salam.
I'm Krista Treat. I'm 25 years old, and I'm a flight attendant at Alaska Airlines. I live in Federal Way. I grew up in Tacoma, Washington. I have a twin sister, identical twin sister. That's been really interesting my whole life. I'm kind of a dork when it comes to my passions, but I have a huge passion for anything that has to do with aviation. It's kind of a dorky passion, but with that comes an awesome job that I actually have the privilege of being a flight attendant. I feel like a passion is something that you would do for free.
Krista, tell us about an injustice in the world you wish you could change.
I grew up with scoliosis. With that, I had to wear a back brace for 2 years in middle school, and I definitely, I don't think I was gonna get emotional. I know what it's like to be picked on. So kind of something that definitely makes me mad is like adolescent bullying. I definitely had like self-conscious issues with my back, with having the back brace and everything. But I feel like it just stirs my heart just because it does hit close to home. So I feel like that's definitely what makes me mad is when I see just children who just are getting bullied. It's like, it's not right. DTE is just all about being different and doing just extraordinary things. And so I think that's just why I love them, because everything about them, whether it's just a random photo shoot in the mud or, you know, random different material on their clothing and stuff, everything about them is just different. And I feel like people just sometime in their life need to be different and take a chance, and this company is just all about just being extraordinary. So when people think about touching someone else's world, sometimes people think that it has to be this huge big ordeal, and that's why a lot of people just don't even do anything. But I feel like anything can touch someone's heart, can touch their world, like even just a simple smile. Do something small, do something big, do whatever you want, just do something.
My name's David, I'm from Seattle. Kind of the vision, I think, really that God's, the place he's put me in is, I think, impacting the culture in a major way. Whether it's through fashion, this is something I haven't really even pursued a whole lot. It kind of just came to me, and I mean, I've done some stuff, a little bit of stuff. So it's not the forefront, but the idea of it is, if God gives me opportunities, I want to be able to seize those moments.
So David, since the theme of this shoot is Touch Your World, talk a little bit about that.
Growing up, the first experience I had leaving this country, I think was like an eye-opener for me, because I grew up here and I figured the whole world was like this. And so it just gives you a real, real clear perspective that, man, life's bigger than us, it's bigger than, you know, what I'm doing. But at the same time, I feel like I have a responsibility with the opportunity, the resources, the place God put me, to make the best of that and be a good steward of those opportunities. Like I might have more opportunities than someone that was born in another country. I didn't choose to be born here, you know. My father was born in Ethiopia. You know, I mean, I could have, you know, I don't know how, but I mean, I could have been born in Ethiopia and my life would be a lot different right now. And so now I'm looking at my life and it's tough sometimes, you know. You're just so used to the comfort around here. I'm like, how am I gonna make a difference? How am I gonna impact my generation, or, you know, even just not get comfortable? What you guys are doing, as far as do the extraordinary, I think everybody was created for greatness. I think everyone was created with a purpose in them. And like, we all know that, but sometimes it's hard to realize that. And I think the hardest part is finding people who are actually for you, which that might sound funny. When you have friends, I got a lot of friends, I know a lot of people, but I can think of probably five people I can count on my hand who are really for me, who are like, man, we want you to succeed more than I want myself to succeed. And so I think even the vision behind Do the Extraordinary, with even with the clothing line, yeah, they want to have some trendy clothes, they want to do something cool, but it's really inspiring that in a generation, in a culture, to do something great, you know, beyond like, you know, what you're with your platform, not just some star, that you could do something great, I could do something great, you know. I mean, not a lot of people know my name, you know, right now, but it's like, hey, I still think I'm doing something great, and no matter what level it is, I think it's a cool vision that you guys are dealing with. Yeah, Do the Extraordinary.
Starvation or some other wretched disease. I would have grown up with no education, just another refugee. I stand here because someone's here. I stand here because someone's there. I know that there's a lot of them out there who's willing and trying to save the life of a child.
Hakuma gun. Lighting another candle. Boom. Another candle. Shakalaka boom. Lighting another candle. Hakuna Matata.